So hello students, welcome to discrete mathematics lecture. Okay, so in this lecture we will see the logical equivalence and involving implications. Okay, so you can see here I have a table of 13 rows. Okay, so in the 13 rows you are getting some expression here. Okay, so here some mathematical logical statement written. Okay, and you need to see these statements are equivalent to this statement. Okay, so statement 1 is here, statement 2 is here. Okay, and these two statements are equivalent. Okay, statement 1 is here, statement 2 is here, and these statements are logically equivalent. Okay, it is very difficult to understand or it is very difficult to memorize all this formula that these are the equivalence or not. Okay, so how we can say that these expressions are equivalent? Okay, means this expression is equivalent to this expression is equivalent to this. How we can say? Okay, so for that we have a method to construct a truth table. Okay, by constructing the truth table we can definitely analyze that these statements are logically equivalent. How? Because whenever you construct a truth table for this statements, you will get a tautology. Okay, you will get a tautology truth table. What is mean by tautology truth table? Means the last column of the truth table is completely true. Okay, so let's see here. Here I have examples. Okay, see here. Truth table for well-formed formula. Okay, so truth table for well-formed formula we have to construct. Okay, if we replace the propositional variables in the formula alpha by the propositions, okay, we get a proposition involving connectives. Okay, see, if alpha involves n propositional constant means this p, q, this p is the one propositional constant, q is the one another propositional constant. Okay, so you need to count how many propositional constant involves in your expression. Okay, so see here, if alpha involves n propositional constant, here we have a two propositional constants. Okay, we get 2 raised to power n. Guys, this is 2 raised to power n possible combinations of truth variables of a proposition replacing the variables. Okay, so you are getting a 2 raised to power n possible combination, guys. See here, you have a two variables, okay, p and q. So you are getting 2 raised to power 2 means 4 combinations. See here, you are getting 4 rows here in this truth table. Okay, so like that you can count how many rows you will get if there are the 3 propositional constant or 4 propositional constant. Okay, so in terms of 3 propositional constant you will get 8 rows, because 2 raised to power 3 you will get 8. Okay, so see here, I have the formula here. Okay, or I have one statement, alpha is equals to p implies q and q implies p. Okay, now you need to check what is the value of alpha. Okay, so see here, the truth table for given well-formed formula is given below. So how you construct the truth table for this statement? Okay, so you need to divide this statement one by one. Okay, so first of all solve this bracket, next solve this bracket, and do and operation in between the results of those two brackets. Okay, so see here, p and q I have, p is ttff, q tftf. Okay, now p implies q. So p implies q, you know, if there is a true and false, then only it is false, otherwise everything is true. So here you can see p and false, true and false you are getting. So this is the false, otherwise everything is true. Okay, now see here, q implies p. Okay, so here also, whenever you are getting true and false, then only it is false. Okay, so you need to see reverse now. Okay, so because this is q implies p, na, that's why tt, so you are getting t, ft, so you are getting t, tf, guys, tf you are getting here, t and f. So whenever you are getting t and f in the implication, that time you are getting false as a result. Okay, ff, so you are getting t. Okay, now what you need to do, you need to do ending between these two columns. Okay, ending in between these two columns. Okay, so what is the formula for ending? If anyone is false, then it is false. So the value of alpha is tfft, because tt you are getting t here, ft you are getting f, tf you are getting f, and tt you are getting t. Okay, So this is called this is how you can construct the truth table for any logical statement. Okay. See here, the first thing we need to check is tautology. Okay. A tautology or the universally true formula is a well-formed formula whose truth value is true. Okay. For all the possible assignments of the truth values. Okay, means all possible combination, the value, the ultimate result is true. The propositional variable. Okay, so see here. Here I have only one propositional variable P. So 2 raised to power 1. So only two combinations I am getting here. Okay, true or false. Okay, and you need to solve this. Okay, so first of all, break this statement P, then negation of P. And then you can take OR operation in between them. Okay. So P is here. Negation of P is here. True ka false. False ka true. Okay. And then you need to do a OR operation. Okay. So in the OR operation, if anyone is true, then it is true. So this is true. This is true. Okay. Next, P or negation P always takes a value true. For all possible truth values of P, it is a tautology. Okay, so this statement is a tautological statement. Okay, so this is how you can identify the statement is tautology or not. Okay. Next is contradiction or the falsity. Okay, so this is completely reverse of tautology. In the tautology, in the last column, you are getting everything is true. Okay, in the contradiction or in the falsity, in the last column, you are getting everything is false. Okay, so contradiction or falsity. A contradiction is a well-formed formula whose truth value is false for all the possible assignments of the truth value to a propositional variable. Okay. So see here, I have this statement. Okay. In this statement, I have only one propositional variable. Okay. So see, P is having a value T and F. Negation of P, true ka false ho jayega, false ka true ho jayega. And you need to do AND operation in between them. Okay, so see here, you are getting false here, you are getting false here. Okay, so P AND negation P always takes a false F for all the possible truth values of P. It is a contradiction. So that this statement is contradiction. In the previous slide, we have seen P OR negation P is always a tautology or always getting a true value. Okay, and here P and negation P is always give you the false value. Okay. Next is contingency. Okay, a well-formed formula which is neither a tautology nor a contradiction is called a contingency. Okay, means most of the time you are getting some true value, some false value in the last column. Okay, so in that case, it is contributed into the contingency. Okay, that is neither true tautology nor contradiction, it is contingency. Okay, thus the contingency is the statement pattern which is either true or false depending on the truth value of its compound statement. Okay, so you need to check again, you need to construct a truth table to check that the statement is contingency or not. Okay. So see here, I have one example. Okay, so these are these example. Negation of P or Q and negation of P and negation of Q are logically equivalent. So you need to show these two statements are logically equivalent or not. So whenever you want to show these two statements are logically equivalent or not, so what you need to do, first of all, construct a truth table for this, next construct the truth table of for this, and then apply the biconditional operator between these two statements. Okay, so see, this is the biconditional operator. Okay, so whenever you apply biconditional operator in between these two statements, and if you are getting all the entries of the truth table as a true, then you can directly claim that these two statements are logically equivalent. Okay. If you are getting false values or true false values, then in that case, you cannot claim that these two statements are logically equivalent. Okay. So see here, I solved that example for you. here p and q are the propositional variables I am having, two variables I am having, that's why two rows I am getting here. Okay, so 2 raised to power 2, 4. Okay, so that's why 4 rows I am getting here. Okay, so 4 rows, so first 2, then this is 2. So you need to calculate these terms also, because you need to, this is the requirement for your expression. Okay, so negation of p bhi aapko lena hai, negation of q bhi yahan pe aapko chahiye. Okay, so first of all, try to get the value of this p or q. Okay, so this is the column for p or q, and then take a negation of this column. So negation of this column is this. Okay, so you are getting the value of this expression in the columns number 6. Okay, now try to solve this. Okay, so negation of p and negation of q. Okay, so apply AND operation between these two columns, you are getting this column. Okay, now this is the 7th column. Okay, now if you want to check these two statements are logically equivalent or not, what you need to do, you need to apply a biconditional operator in between them. Okay, so what is the rule for biconditional operator? If both the propositional variables has a same values, then only you are getting a true. Okay, if the both propositional variable has a same value, then you are getting a true. Same value means, if p is true, then q is also true. If p is false, then q is also false. In that case, you will get a true. Okay, see here, f, you are getting true. f, you are getting true. f, you are getting true. And t, you are getting true. Why? Because these two are same. Okay. We observe that the truth table of negation in bracket p or q and negation p and negation q agree for all the possible combinations of truth table values of p and q. Okay, that's why you are, if you are getting tautology here, then directly you claim that these two statements are logically equivalent. Okay, so you need not to remember any formula. Okay guys, whenever you want to prove or whenever you want to show these statements are equivalent or not, so you need to construct this truth table and you show that last column is tautology, and that's why they are equivalence. So these are the some example guys. You need to solve this example, determine which whether each of the following form is tautology or a contradiction or neither. Okay, so you need to solve this numerical. Okay, so I will leave this topic for you. Okay, so I have the solution here also, so I am giving you the solution. Okay, first of all you try this. Okay, and after that you check your solution with my this video. Okay, so I am just giving you the solution. Okay, see here, this is the solution of first. Okay, so first solution, in the first see here, in the last you are getting all the entries as true, that's why this first statement is tautology. Okay, the next statement, in the last column you are getting all the values as false, that's why this second statement is the contradiction statement. In the third, the last column is completely false, that's why this is a contradiction. Okay, and this is fourth guys. In the fourth also, you are getting some true entries and some false entry, that's why it is a contingency. Okay, this is not a tautology, not a contradiction, this is a contingency. I hope you are getting my point guys. You solve this numericals by your own, after that check your solution with my this truth table. Okay, if you are getting a same truth table, then that is fine. Okay, otherwise you need to do a practice of this, how to construct this truth table. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can ask me into the comment section guys. I will definitely solve your doubt. Okay, in the next lecture we will see the predicates and the quantifiers. Thank you.